Hi, Josh Sussman. How you doing? Hello, Mr. Josh. I love your content, and I love your positivity. Like, I know that sometimes I struggle a lot emotionally. Like, my uncle says that if you're LGBTQ, if you're trans, how can you be a Star Wars Expanded Universe fan? Like, and all those, you know, improper, rude, disrespectful things. You really make my day. And that quarantine video with Sarah Connor, very cool and chill, you know? Incredibly chill. To a point where, you know, it's just crazy how you're a fan of me. And that, you know, even if all my craziness, that you just always come back and just share your own personal experience that not only I can relate to, but that the whole world can relate to. Like, you know, with the haters. Yeah, I got a lot of haters out there, you know? A lot of people hate on me, you know? In fact, thousands upon thousands of people send me hate, and they don't follow me, you know, they just say some disrespectful things, how, you know, you're a man, you're not a woman, you're a man, and that, you know, if you're really a woman, check under your pants, or check under your shorts, and some derogatory terms like that. And I know that in the past I called a classmate gay, Josh Sussman, but I've learned from that, and I always never liked, you know, unacceptance. Not just unacceptance, like, you don't have to accept me, but you gotta respect me like a human being I am, and, you know, there's a lot of derogatory terms out there, like when people say that queer, or queer, 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 it's like they're treating us like a creature, not like a beautiful human that we are, with so much endless creativity, possibilities, and there's like 8 billion different types of personalities out there, I bet you. People think that, oh, there's the nice person, yeah, there's the chill personality. But there's 8 billion different types of personalities and identities, and that there's so many identities that we neglect. And, again, you know, with the bullying and the LGBTQ profiling, say that if you're LGBTQ, you gotta be a certain way. I wanna defy that. I wanna show that you can be anything you want. And really, that life is paradise, and that life is so beautiful if you believe in it. Just like with the Phantom Menace, they're so negative. The Phantom Menace always pushed so much hate towards the Star Wars, Disney Star Wars. Like, for me, I hate Disney Star Wars. I don't like Disney Star Wars at all, but at the end, it's us fans that create Star Wars and give Star Wars what it is and the power it is, and that without, you know, the fan reaction or without the fan support, that Star Wars just wouldn't be the way it is today, you know? In 1977, May 25th, 1977, George created this franchise. And he didn't know that it would even be a franchise. He created one film called Star Wars in May 25th, 1977. And the positive fan reaction was something that, you know, was unbelievably monumental, in that it was monumental in cinematic history. And for the haters of the EU or haters of Star Wars, I don't hate them. Like, you know, this world is so precious, and us humans are so precious as children of God, that, you know, I don't hate, but I just hate it when the people think like that, you know. The EU, the Star Wars Expanded Universe, has so much detailed lore in the books. As you know, Josh Sussman, you know, Drake and Josh, actor, he's also on TikTok. And also we have mutual friends. We're mutual friends with Kai Baldwin, which is so awesome and cool. Since I knew Kai Baldwin since 2015. So yeah, I'm a follower of Kai Baldwin, and he knows who I am. I DM him from time to time. And just that, you know, I wanna create a space where there's so many mutual friends, where, you know, it's a beautiful community where we never regret going live. Like, you know, sometimes I go live just to escape my depression. I wanna become something much more greater. I wanna become, you know, not just Star Wars and me representing Star Wars for my passion, but for me to represent Star Wars in the life that I wish it had. Like, when I was growing up, people, they never respected me, and especially my uncle doesn't respect my passion for the Star Wars Expanded Universe, and just very much a shame. Like, you like The Weeknd? I love The Weeknd so much. Much on the regular. We all let the hands fly, we all let it go. And XO, then it gotta go. I just want a new war for a kid show. This song is perfect for me, this is my perfect vocal range. Josh Sussman is such an iconic legend. Josh Sussman is such an awesome person. So kind and genuine and also geeky. We're both geeky, so we get along really well. And I watch your prank videos too. Your old prank videos where you go up to strangers and you let them know, like, I like your hair. I like the way I like your hair. I like your look. You look fun. And just all your chill pranks. You need to do cool. You need to do way more prank videos. I think that your personality, just, you know, this very ball of fun personality, like, you know, like, you know, the way I have my personality, I think we can understand each other well, you know, and the language too. We both communicate in a similar type of language where we express our geekiness 100% fully, you know. We don't let anyone tell us that we're too geeky or that we gotta change, you know. If those people that tell us to change, screw them, you know. They're probably jealous that they aren't as geeky and pretty like me, you know what I mean? But yeah, Troye Sivan's song really calmed me down. When I have a depression, I always remember his voice and just, it's like a lullaby, like a calm, familiar lullaby that I grew up with. Yes, I've been following Troye Sivan for a long time, Josh. And I know that you just discovered The Weeknd, but yeah, I think that we should communicate more. Like, I know that you have Cameo. Like, do you think I should start a Cameo? I have a small following. I have 17,000 followers. 17,000. Hopefully one day I get 400,000 followers. That would be really beautiful, cool, and awesome, and just an absolute dream, you know, a miracle. But yeah, we gotta communicate more. If you could ever video call me on your free time, I would really appreciate that, because I really want to get to know you in a much more deeper level, that we're, you know, we're both fun, geeky balls of joy. That's what, you know, that's what people think we are. But I want people to think even more of us as, you know, real creators who are so passionate and don't give a damn what people think and are able to express ourselves fully 150,000%. Like, I express myself so much in my content, and that's, you know, that's just the start of it. I want to put my voice to the entire world. I want to represent Star Wars, the expanding universe, as a fan, and how, you know, true diversity of Star Wars, that I'm an Asian bilingual Vietnamese girl, and I'm an Asian bilingual Vietnamese American girl, and that doesn't change anything about me as a Star Wars fan. Like, I can speak my own language, Vietnamese, and still be a Star Wars expanded fan and a huge, huge fan. And you make me feel so special that you even came to watch my video. It's crazy that, you know, you even recognize me. Like, I didn't expect you to watch my video. I mean, I know who you are, and I've seen you even before you met me. And I knew you from Greg and Josh, and just the fact that you discovered me was just a total crazy, spontaneous surprise, you know? And I love it. I live for surprises. I live for these surprises, like these negative or positive surprises that could make us not just different, because difference is a state of mind. Like, you know, difference is all, you know, we're all different, but true difference is the state of diversity, the resemblance of diversity, what diversity really is and has always been, you know. Being different, being happy while being different, and being happy while alive, and using this to increase our life expectancy. If all of us had a passion that, you know, if all of us had a passion that everyone, you know, appreciated, and if everyone appreciated our passion with so much love and compassion, then definitely this world would be in a much better place and people would live longer. I believe that people don't live as long as they possibly be because of this illness that, you know, health illnesses that, you know, are stemmed from, you know, lack of, like, when you really want to do something and when you're so passionate about something and you stop people from doing that, that's just wrong and so messed up and hurtful. And I'm not about that. I'm the opposite of that. I don't care how crazy I am, how crazy I look. Like, right now, as a girl, as a transgender girl, like, yeah, I'm talking to a doctor to start taking hormones, and you know what I mean. Like, I'm a trans, I'm a girl, I'm female, and I'm totally about diversity in the right way. Like, I hate, I mean, I don't hate, but I don't like The Rise of Skywalker that much. I don't like The Force Awakens. I don't like them as much as, you know, the original trilogy, prequel trilogy. But, you know, I want to teach people that diversity doesn't have to be negative. It could be very positive in that, you know, if we implement the authenticity of George Lucas and his vision for the Star Wars expanded universe and just show diversity the way it has always been, then the Star Wars franchise would be in such a greater state. I'm entirely sure, and I'm entirely positive about that. You know me of my huge Star Wars collection. That's just not just the collection to brag and show that, you know, I got everything, but I mean, I want to go even crazier. I want to do some crazy content that no one has ever watched before. I want to be the Tan Lee. I want to get the recognition I deserve as a true fan of the Star Wars Expanded Universe, irregardless that I'm a bilingual Vietnamese girl. And that, you know, that I'm pretty. I don't want people to follow me just because I'm pretty. I want people to follow me because they follow my ideology to the death. They follow my ideology so much that, you know, that no matter how broken you are, how different you are, that you can make everything magic. Just think about the magic in art. Think about the magic in humanity. That we're all alive and that the sun is waking us every day. Life is so beautiful. Life is way too beautiful, Josh Sussman. Every time you come to my life, you're just that beacon of hope. Not to sound cliche, but really. So I love when you come unexpected. Justice Man is an icon and legend. I love this song so much, Justice Man. You know I love The Weeknd so much, Justice Man. Justice Man is awesome, Justice Man. Justice Man is a legend, and a Star Wars Expanded Universe fan, and we get along really well, and I'm a big fan of his. Justice Man is just one of a kind. Justice Man is always a big fan of Stanley and Tanley, Stanley Tanley. No, I shouldn't even say that. You know, I heard that, you know, you obviously are a big fan of Stan Lee. My name, Tan Lee, is named off Stan Lee, you know. And I want people to appreciate that. I want people to recognize that. Like, my name is not Tan Lee for some reason. God wanted my name to be Tan Lee in honor of the great Stan Lee. And I name my sons or my daughters Georgia or Georgina. Georgina Lucas. I think that's just so beautiful. I love the name Anakin. I love the name Anakin so much, but, you know, it's just not for me, you know. The name Anakin is such a powerful emotional name, but it has so much darkness. And not that I'm terrified of the darkness, but the darkness is something that, you know, I am intimidated to name my child or if I ever have kids, you know. But Stan Lee is an icon legend, and I will never forget Stan Lee. Just like, you know, I will never forget George Lucas, who created the Star Wars Expanded Universe. And John Williams, too, you know. Don't even get me started with John Williams. I love John Williams so much. His music has got me through the darkest times. Like, when I was 14 years old, I felt so depressed and weak that I wanted to give up. And I don't even think my family understands this, but when I was 14 years old, I was about to give up on life. I was just so confused. No friends, no supporters, no real supporters, no fan base, nothing. I didn't have the 17,000 followers I have today. I didn't have all these hundreds of thousands of views every month. I wasn't, you know, the Tan Lee, the Star Wars girl. I was known as this weird outcast by my family, you know, with really no purpose in life other than being a regular engineer, paying the bills. I didn't even think my story's fantasy could even become reality, so if anyone calls me a fake Star Wars fan, I'm gonna have to pull the middle on them, you know? Pull the middle on them, you know? Because really, you know, if you ever watch my videos, you know that everything about me is about Star Wars, and that I would never change, even if the haters hate on me every single day, I would never change. Changing is beyond my realm of thinking, you know? Why change when you could be the most beautiful person in the world and that God gave us so much life? And God and Jesus Christ, Allah, Moses, Muhammad has given us so much life. And I'm really religious emotionally. And Star Wars is a huge part of my religion. Not to say that Star Wars is nonfiction, because we don't know. It could very well be real that there's a long universe, Star Wars, expanding universe, a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, and we don't even know it. But really, you know, Star Wars has taught me so much about religion. It's taught me so much about humanity and faith and diversity and how diversity is natural, and that, you know, if you're going to blame something on diversity, it's always invalid, because the diversity in me is booming, you know. I'm booming. I'm getting, you know, I'm getting my passion through. And when people hate on me because I'm different, because I'm a, you know, Josh Sussman, I know you're watching this right now, Josh Sussman, that I'm a bilingual, that I'm a Vietnamese girl, and that I cannot be a Star Wars fan, it really makes me cry and it makes me feel so, so emotional, you know? I think people should be more mature than this, you know? Like, really, like, if they still thinking like that, they should be more mature. Like, grow up. Grow the F up. I watch a lot of R-rated mature films, but I want to keep my videos PG, PG clean, family-friendly. No, not really. I just want to be real, you know? And I want to be as real as I can possibly be R-rated mature content or what, you know? But Josh is awesome. You know, we got to go to the convention center. We got to do something. We got, you know, when I meet you at the convention and you recognize who I am and you know my passion and you know who I am and we're speaking one-on-one about the Star Wars fandom and the Star Wars expanding universe and the Marvel universe and the DC universe and just an entire geek fandom, and we're just speaking one-on-one, you know, because I know that you're a fan of my videos and that, you know, if I can make happy at least a little bit, damn, I've accomplished so much in my damn life, you know. Even making one person happy is just very open-minded, you know. Open-minding, you know. Opening of the mind. And people think about these numbers and views. Fuck the fame, you know. I'm more than the fame. I'm everything, you know. I know that I'm a legend and an icon, and if people hate on me, damn, they're insecure. And I really care for those people that hate on me, you know. If they're struggling emotionally, if they're insecure, Josh Sussman, you know, I really want to connect with them. Just like Josh, when they tell you that you were at, they were at your booth, and that you ignored them, and that you didn't even want to give them a look or talk to them. Like that example, I got to be honest with you, you know. It's a shame that they try to hate on really genuine and kind people and judge people just for their online persona or the way they act or their role. Like, you know, us geeky people or us fans of the Star Wars expanding universe definitely need a much more voice, and we need to, I want there to be endless collaboration between the Star Wars expanding universe and the mainstream culture that's now on the news or trending today, you know? I think that would be gold if we can able to, you know, show that, you know, just not, you know, because the Disney Star Wars, I don't really want the Disney Star Wars to be mainstream. I would do anything for the Star Wars expanding universe to be mainstream, and not Disney Star Wars, honestly. Not to push Disney Star Wars away, but I want Disney Star Wars to be more like a, I want Disney Star Wars to be more like the fan fiction it is, because really, Disney Star Wars, it's a fan fiction, and you know my opinions. The Force Awakens was a, I didn't like The Force Awakens. I love the cinematography. It was one of the best. I love the music. I love everything. But the story was just whack, and it was so slow-paced, and I mean, the Disney Star Wars, it doesn't do anything for Star Wars. It doesn't add anything. It just takes away from the raw authenticity of Star Wars and George Lucas, and I'm not a hater. Why would I hate when I can be positive, you know? I try not to hate on Disney that much, you know? But I think the representation is struggling right now, because, you know, they can say it's all forced, it's all an agenda, but in reality, you know, that's hard to say, you know? Like, our agendas, you know, perpetuated, is it, you know, is it force or is it real? That's the real question there, you know. And if you can answer the question, then you don't need to go any further. Josh Sussman, if we go to the convention, let's do, we should do a meetup, or we should, you and me, we should be booth by booth, and I think that you and me, we could talk forever and never get bored. I think that's freaking awesome. The fact that you can talk to someone forever and never get damn bored, that's the magic in humanity. That's the real human relationship that binds and penetrates us like galactic glue. Yeah, another Star Wars quote, like, yeah. And another happy landing, yeah. And every time, you know, I find someone that I can talk to about the Star Wars expanding universe so fluidly and just completely, you know, occupying the time that we have on Earth, it's like another happy landing, because if I could, you know, talk about Star Wars all day, I totally would, because it is who I am. It created me. It didn't create me literally, like, biologically, but I mean, it created who I am. It created the fact that I am strong, I'm independent, and I'm a transgender girl, and a proud transgender girl to be a huge, giant Star Wars expanding universe fan, you know what I mean? Need an info. Yeah, but The Weeknd is a really interesting artist, and I think that we could bond even more. Not just geek culture or Marvel Universe or DC Universe or Terminator or Spawn or, you know, Star Trek or Star Wars Expanding Universe. We could bond through music. If we can bond through music, then yeah, we're gonna be best friends, you know. One day I'll move to Hollywood. One day I'll have enough money to move to Hollywood. And that day is coming soon, you know. I believe in it. I believe that anything's possible. That it's our very doubt that hinder us from achieving endless success, you know. It's the very doubt inside us. And that, you know, I don't shame anyone that doesn't believe in themselves, but I am strong-minded, and I know that there is a place for everyone on this earth. And people just haven't found it yet. Very religious. I'm very religious. And the fact that I'm very religious, I think it's just beautiful. The fact that I can use religion to protect me in the darkest times and to give me valid and reason and strength and dignity and integrity as a human being, as a truthful follower of Jesus Christ, you know, any religion. I follow a lot too, but I disagree with some of the Quran, you know, obviously. But I respect religion and culture so much to the point where, you know, it makes me Tan Lee. It makes me the girl that I am, you know, Tan Lee, the Star Wars Expanded Universe girl, who loves to sing the Weeknd song and the Troye Sivan songs, who love to sing. Man, I think, I'm still trying to create identity for myself. If one day I can make original songs, then that would be beyond awesome and cool and amazing, you know? I would love to sing original songs. But yeah, Mr. Josh Sussman, until next time, may the force be with you. I know this is long, but I hope you watch the whole video and really think about it, and we're fans. We're fans of each other, and we're friends. Definitely.